Ian, you've been involved for years. I mean, you must be still in awe sometimes of some of the stories and some of the work that goes on at grassroots level in Welsh football.
Yeah, I think that's what it's all about. Everyone loves the, when you get to the top end of it, but to get to the top end, it's got to be right at the bottom end, and the grassroots side of it, and the people, the volunteers that put the work in, they don't get paid to doing that. But to see the boys and girls come through eventually and have a better life, I think, and they keep themselves fit and all that. And for me, that's enjoyment that they see at the end of the day.
You made a fantastic career in football. Does it bring it all back to you about the days up in Deeside when, you know, I suppose you were the school teachers, the volunteers, the clubs you were playing for?
But when you're a kid, you don't realise that. It's only when you finish playing. I was lucky enough to play at the top level, but I think when you're a kid, you take it for granted, you know, that these people giving you lifts and all that to games and all that, and, you know, we're putting the nets out and all that, and the referees and people, you know, looking after the pitches and everything. They're doing it for nothing, but as a kid, you take it for granted. But when you go to the top, it's even worse, you know, because they're people get paid for it. But it's when you come back down again and you see all this and see the work that the Welsh FA Trust are doing. I think that's what it's all about. And as you get older, you get more experienced. And I think you want to give your kids everything that you didn't have yourself.
Neil Wood was saying about the chief executive of the Trust about, you know, giving the awards and the people who receive the awards. You see how appreciative they are that their work is being recognised. They like the fact that someone is recognising that all that hard work is worthwhile.
Well, that's what it's all about. I think, you know, until maybe 5 or 6 years ago, this wasn't happening. And when you even look at tonight, and for them to be the nominees now, it's a great thing for them. So I think what the Welsh FA Trust has done, they brought it on to today's world where, you know, I think in like 20, 30 years ago, people were still doing this, but mostly they weren't getting recognised. So what it is now is to be recognised, even as a nominee. But now, but the winner, it's great for the boys and girls to come in at that, but also for them to think, no, yeah, people are noticing what we want. You know, we are doing something. And they don't recognise themselves. It's the people that are putting their names forward for that. And by doing that, I think they get self-satisfaction. I think it's one night a year that these people must think, oh, I'm going to enjoy myself.
And in the various roles you have, you travel the world. How impressed are you when you look back home at what's going on at grassroots level in Wales?
Well, I think we've come on over the last 5 years. When you look at it, we've got 6 stars now, you know, for the UEFA and all that, and there's 7 that you can get. And I think the work has gone in since I've been here the last 4 or 5 years. Now, the improvements has made with the Welsh FA Trust is gone, but we still need more and more to do that. You know, I think it's for the kids to come on at any level, they need the coaches. And I think what the Welsh FA Trust are doing also, obviously with the help of McDonald's and all that, is getting these coaches to be coaches. You have to coach the coaches. It's like going to school. If you're paying for kids to go to school, you've got the best coaches. But what we're doing here is, you're not paying to do anything, but what you're doing here is you need to be coached right. If you coach wrong and everything, kids listen and believe what the coach is saying is right. But I think over the last 4 or 5 years, what we've done is got the right coaches in all over Wales and all that. And by doing that, and I think Oisin Roberts as well, he's come the technical director, and you look at the chief exec with Neil Ward and everything, they've seen the light, and they're most probably 5 or 6 years ahead of the time because they've listened to what UEFA are saying. And I think from that point of view, they've gone the right way, and I think we're getting the right coaches at this moment in time.
That's great. Thanks a lot, Ian.